Today we'll be talking about peripheral parenteral nutrition, otherwise called PPN. I wanted to cover this because when we talk about TPN, a lot of times we're focusing on central parenteral nutrition or CPN, and some interns aren't always aware of the difference. The difference between a peripheral and a central line is determined by where the end of the catheter tip is. A peripheral catheter ends in a peripheral vein, either in the hand or an arm. For an adult, this would be a midline or a short peripheral intravenous cannula. In a central line, the catheter tip reaches the central circulation, either in the lower third of the superior vena cava or cava atrial junction, and if it's placed in the femoral vein, within the inferior vena cava vein, above the diaphragm. Examples of a central line are a PICC line, implanted port, tunnel catheter, dialysis catheter, or umbilical catheter. Here's a picture of a peripheral line, and here's a picture of a central line. Peripheral lines are used for TPN if a central line can't be accessed or if the patient is unable to use other forms of nutrition support. PPN is diluted because the osmolarity needs to be less than 900 per liter. There are high rates of technical failures with PPN, the most common being leaking of fluids from the catheter or inflammation of the vein. Therefore, PPN is usually used short-term and needs to be reinserted frequently. The amount of dextrose you can give in a PPN is often limited because high concentrations of dextrose can cause thrombophlebitis. This is because high concentrations of dextrose will increase the osmolarity of the solution. Some facilities will use glycerol instead of dextrose, which will provide 4.3 calories per gram instead of 3.4 calories per gram, but this is not common. Since the dextrose is usually limited in a PPN, lipids are often given to help meet calorie needs. Like I mentioned before, the osmolarity should be below 900 milliosmoles per liter, so PPN is not a good option for patients with a fluid restriction. Check out my video on calculating a TPN for more information on this. Here is a list of the osmolarity for each gram of dextrose, amino acid, fats, and electrolytes. Note that this is in grams, not milliliters, so fat emulsion usually contributes very little to the total osmolarity. Now let's practice. Let's say we have a patient who needs 2,000 calories and 80 grams of protein. First, we'll calculate how many calories they'll receive from 80 grams of amino acids. So multiply 80 grams times 4 calories per gram, which equals 320 calories from amino acids. Then calculate the remaining numbers of calories needed from fat and dextrose. So subtract 320 calories of amino acids from 2,000 calories, which equals 1,680 calories needed from fat and dextrose. Third, calculate calories provided from lipids. 250 milliliters of 20% lipids equals 500 calories, and you can check out some of my other videos for more information on this. Then, calculate the remaining number of calories needed from dextrose. 2,000 calories minus 300 calories from amino acids minus 500 calories from lipids equals 1,180 calories needed from dextrose. Then calculate the grams of dextrose needed to meet the calorie needs. 1,180 calories divided by 3.4 calories per gram of dextrose equals 347 grams of dextrose. Then we'll calculate the osmolarity using that table I showed before. The osmolarity is 3,935 milliosmoles per liter. To reach our goal of less than 900, we'll either need to increase the fluid or dilute the solution, or change the composition of the PPN. You'll see when we increase the fluid to 5 liters, the osmolarity was below 900, but 5 liters may be too much fluid for the patient. If we only give the patient 3 liters, the osmolarity will be too high. So let's try increasing the protein and decreasing the dextrose. If you were unable to change the macronutrients because the patient could only have a limited number of protein, you would either have to increase the fluid volume or not meet 100% of the patient's calorie needs. We went through all of the steps, listed on the previous slide, but increase the protein to 105 grams and decrease the dextrose to 317 grams. We also included 250 milliliters of 20% lipids. The total osmolarity was decreased to 2,695 milliosmoles per liter. If we provide 3 liters of fluid, the osmolarity will decrease to 898, which meets our goal. Thanks for watching. Comment below if you have any questions and make sure to subscribe. Thank you.